नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय सेल्फ जेवी एंड डॉक्टर आस्था सिकरवार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस केस टेकिंग, जो कि अफोरिज्म नंबर 83 से 104 तक ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन में दी गई है। केस टेकिंग इज अ unique art of getting into conversation, observation and collecting information from patient as well as from bystanders to define the patient as a person and the disease. Case taking is the process of collecting all the facts about the patient using various tools like observation, perception, history taking given by the patient, attendant, clinical examination, etc., in order to find a remedy for the patient using our knowledge of homeopathic materia medica, organ of medicine, and repertory. According to Sturt clause, the purpose of homeopathic examination is to bring out the symptoms of the patient in such a way as to permit their comparison with the symptoms of the materia medica for the purpose of selecting the similar or homeopathic remedy. Case taking a social interaction between a physician and patient under certain predetermined conditions. Tiwari says it works like a ventilator through which the patient ventilates his problems. Dr. J.T. Kent says case taking is the first step and the outcome of treatment entirely depends upon the success of this first step. Objective of case taking: collection of all the facts pertaining to the patient which may help in reaching to the totality of the patient and thereby helping in finding the correct simulimum. It is also said that a well taken is a case half cured. अगर हम केस को प्रॉपरली लेंगे तो वो आधा हमारा ऐसे ही ठीक होगा, क्योंकि जब केस ठीक लिया जाएगा तो हमारी टोटैलिटी सही बनेगी, टोटैलिटी सही बनेगी तभी हमारी जो सिमिलिमम और जो करेक्ट होम्योपैथिक रेमेडी निकल के आएगी तभी हमारा पेशेंट क्योर कहलाएगा। डॉक्टर सैमुअल हैनीमैन्स गाइडलाइंस रिगार्डिंग द आर्ट ऑफ केस टेकिंग। डॉक्टर हैनीमैन इन हिज ऑर्गन ऑफ मेडिसिन अफोरिजम्स नंबर 83 to 104 has given the following instruction regarding the method of case taking. 83 to 90 general instruction, 91 to 93 patients coming from other physicians, 94 to 98 difficulties in chronic case taking, 99 acute case taking, 100 and 102 tak epidemic and sporadic diseases, 103 chronic miasmatic maladies, 104 record keeping. In aphorism number 83, Dr. Hahnemann says case taking requires or demands some qualities from the physician that are freedom from prejudice, sound senses, attention in observing, fidelity, matlab faithfulness in tracing the picture of the diseases. According to H.A. Robert, attitude of physician should be absolute rest and poise with no preconceived ideas or prejudice. In aphorism number 84, Dr. Hahnemann says physician should write down accurately all that the patient and his friends have told him in the very expressions used by them. The physician sees, hears, and remarks by his senses what there is an altered and unusual character about patient. Footnote: every interruption breakdowns the chain of thought of the patient. So in middle, physician should not interrupt the patient. In aphorism number 85, Dr. Hahnemann says physicians should begin a fresh line with very new circumstance mentioned by the patient or his friends. Aphorism number 86, Dr. Hahnemann says when the narrators have finished what they would say of their own accord, The physician then reverts to each particular symptom and elicits more precious information. Once the patient has finished his symptoms, then again physician should go from the number one symptom and start from there only. Kent asks to divide the page into three sections. First section deals with date and remedies. Second, the complaint of patient. And third, their modalities. Stuart Claus asks to leave space between symptoms so that we can add it to later, if any. He asks to divide page into three for convenience, like Kent. P.A. Smith asks to divide page into two halves for writing pathognomic symptoms of disease and characteristic symptoms of the case separately. Aphorism number 87 says, physician should not ask yes or no question. Should not ask any leading question that itself suggests an answer. In aphorism number 88 and 82, the physician asks functions of the body and the state of his disposition or mind. Footnote in 6th edition of 89, Master advises to note the character of menstruation and other discharges, etc. Aphorism number 19. Physician has to note down his own observations about the individual peculiarity of the patient in disease and health. Footnote, for example, color of tongue, breathing, smell from mouth, expression, power of eyes, pupils, contracted or dilated. Pierre Smith explained about different types of pupil. Patient comes from other physician. 91, chronic cases, what to do? 92, acute cases, what to do? 93, obvious cause, chronic or acute, what to do? Dr. J.T. Kent also mentioned the same statement about dealing patient from other physician. Footnote 93, any causes of this graceful character by skillful framing of questions or by private information. Aphorism number 94 to 98 deals with difficulties in case taking in case of chronic diseases. 94 aphorism, maintaining causes. While inquiring into the state of chronic diseases, the particular circumstances of the patient with regard to his occupations, his usual mode of living and diet, his domestic situation, and so forth must be well considered. C.M. Boger says that extrinsic causes are more accessible and therefore more accurately defined, like injuries, state of the weather, heat, cold, dampness, physical exertion, etc. Autogenetic causes often have mental state as their starting point, like effects of grief, worry, or fright. First, objective changes noted by the attendant. Second, close scrutiny and interpretation of the speech, action, and countenance by the physician. Third, an intonation of the voice may sometimes explain a particular symptom. Aphorism number 94, footnote, female case taking 7 points. Aphorism number 95, about lesser accessory symptoms. Symptoms which are often present with meaning, very useful in determining the choice of the remedy and regard them as most necessary part of their condition, the real feeling of which they have all well forgotten and can scarcely believe that these greater or lesser deviations from healthy state can have any connection with their principal malady. Aphorism number 96. Yeh abhi chronic case taking chal rahi thi, theek hai na? Ab aphorism number 96 mein bataya gaya hypochondriacs or and other persons of great sensitiveness and impatience of suffering. जो hypochondriac patient होते हैं वो अपनी problems को बड़ा चढ़ा के बोलते हैं बहुत, जिससे कि वो doctor का एक जो gain होता है confidence gain कर ले और वो चाहते हैं कि इसके बाद जो patient है doctor है उनको बहुत अच्छी दवा देगा. Footnote, placebo. Aphorism number 97. partially from indolence, partially from false modesty, partially from a kind of mildness of disposition or weakness of mind. Aphorism number 98. As certainly as we should listen particularly to the patient's description of his sufferings and sensations and attach credence especially to his own expression wherewith he endeavors to make us understand his ailments, because in the mouth of his friends and attendants they are usually altered and erroneously stated. Aphorism 99. Investigation of acute diseases is much the easiest for the physician, because जो भी sufferings होते हैं वो patient की बहुत recent होती है, तो patient को सब कुछ याद होता है acute diseases के case में. Kent and H. A. Robert advises not to prescribe for an acute and chronic troubles together. H. A. Robert says that the picture of the chronic underlying conditions are displayed most plainly at the end of an acute attack. These symptoms are mostly not the sequel of acute disease but clearly picture of chronic condition. Aphorism 100-102. Epidemic disease is medicine for epidemic diseases. Epidemic disease is the one of the type of acute diseases. Epidemic disease ke condition mein hum log genus epidemias dete hain. 103. Miasmatic chronic maladies. इसमें क्रॉनिक डिजीज आ जाते हैं. 104. When the totality of the symptom that specially mark and distinguish the case of disease, or in other words when the picture of the disease whatever be its kind is once accurately sketched, the most difficult part of the task is accomplished. The physician has then the picture of the disease. This is all about case taking in homeopathy. This session powered by digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention it in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.